Great. So just two more questions then. One of them is about filters setup.
Okay.
Yeah, I saw this
What
question.
about?
Setting up filters, and it's from Molly. So I think that Molly is asking about how to set up filters for a category landing page. That's what I'm assuming.
Okay. So filters are attributes that are either drop-down or multi-select attributes, or it could be price attributes, that you'll see there's a setting in the storefront properties, which is filters, and you can have an option of filterable with results and filterable without results. So they need to fit those two, that criteria of the type of attribute it is a drop-down or a multi-select, and it has to be assigned as a filterable attribute. And if it is, and then you have a product which has the value and that attribute assigned to it, then when you create a page, that filter should appear. The category page itself needs to be an anchor category, so it needs to be set in the display settings an anchor category for that to appear. That is by default, it does that. So you'd have to create a category and purposely say, I don't want filters to appear in it for it not to appear. But really, the main thing is that you create a product, you have the attribute assigned that is, let's say, the size. So you have an attribute which is a drop-down attribute which says whether it's a small, medium, or large product, and then you assign that value to the product when you're creating it. And as long as that attribute is an attribute type that can be filterable, so again, look at the storefront properties of that attribute, then it will appear in the filter. That's quite a very specific kind of answer to that. I don't know whether that answers the question, but that's how you'd certainly get something into the filters.